Chris Caney, we are going viral. So CC touched on this earlier today. CC, another season is in the books from the Chris Caney Camp of Champions. Chris, tell us about what you're up to this summer.
This is awesome.
Well, this is cool. I do this every year. That was our ninth camp that we've hosted here in Manhattan. And it's an opportunity for me to combine my passion for football and working with young kids and being able to instill some core things with them, you know, leadership, work ethic, communication skills, all of those things, things that transcend the sport. It's an opportunity for me to work with them and try to teach them that at an early age. So it's really cool.
And also, man, you open it up for boys and for girls.
For girls,
yeah. Girls out there participating. Great job. There's a great legacy in the NFL as far as the things the players do in the community. We don't do enough time. If someone gets arrested, we spend all this time, but we'll give a one-minute hit on someone doing something in the community. Keep up the good work. We got a lot of guys out there doing positive things out there, and the kids need it.
That's a good point. Really good stuff. Thanks for sharing that with us, Chris. All right, let's talk some Aaron Rodgers now. New season, new head coach. We assumed no new tension between coach and quarterback like there was in the former coaching regime. But Matt LaFleur said earlier this offseason he plans on limiting Aaron Rodgers at the line of scrimmage. Rodgers, though, seemingly unfazed by the audible issue, saying yesterday, "With me, I will do things that other quarterbacks just can't do or just haven't done." Chris Caney, you're shaking your head, dying to know what your reaction is to what Aaron Rodgers said.
Canty, I think I know why you're laughing, but okay. Man, I gotta tell this story. And there were some times they sent in plays, and I kind of changed what I was getting.
Mm-hmm.
I told the quarterback, right now, don't think that's going to be available. I'm going to do this. He's like, okay, as long as you deal with the coach and the quarterback. Warren Moon taught me that. Warren Moon taught me you can change stuff. And when it gets in the meeting, the biggest man will stand up. Warren used to blame it on himself. I used to do something. He'd be like, hey, coach, that's my fault. I told him. I was like, what? Really? No. So I utilized
that. That's true. That happens.
Warren's left. So Aaron, to me, when I read those comments and you start laughing, you'd be surprised in NFL locker rooms, offense and defense, how much guys ad-lib.
No, you're absolutely right. And it's one of those things as a player, if you have the trust of the coaching staff, you know, that's one of those where you have a feel for the flow of the game. Maybe you see something or you know something will work that they don't necessarily see up in the press box. So from a player standpoint, I understand what Aaron Rodgers is talking about. I just want Aaron Rodgers with this situation to keep an open mind. We all recognize that Matt LaFleur is one of the youngest coaches that we got in the National Football League. But as Tom Coughlin used to tell us as players, you can learn from anybody. And so Aaron Rodgers, a two-time MVP, Super Bowl championship on his resume, I just don't want him to think that Matt LaFleur can't teach him anything, because Matt LaFleur was brought there to take some of the pressure off Aaron Rodgers, to remove some of the heavy lifting so he can go out there and do what he does best, which is be one of the best quarterbacks in our league. So I look at what Matt LaFleur has done in his stops as an offensive coordinator and as a position coach. Keep in mind, Matt LaFleur was the quarterback's coach in Atlanta when Matt Ryan had that MVP season back in 2016. I mean, you saw what he was able to do with Jared Goff in year two with the LA Rams. And then, of course, down there in Tennessee, that was a team that ran the football and played really good defense. They were a top 10 rushing outfit, both in attempts and yards. And so when I look at what Aaron Rodgers has had to work with and the balance or lack thereof from the Green Bay Packers standpoint, Aaron Rodgers has never had a rushing attack that has been top 10 in yards and attempts since he took over as a starting quarterback. So, I mean, in order to make things a little bit easier on him, you're going to have more balance in that offense. I think Matt LaFleur wants to bring that to the table. I just hope that Aaron Rodgers isn't resistant to it.
Right. It can't be a one-way street. Like, now that goes in this regard as well. Matt LaFleur, we know it's the Shanahan school of go to the – Gary Kubiak did this in Houston, where the quarterback –
You did it in Baltimore, too.
Absolutely.
You did it in Baltimore, too.
Matt Schaub goes to line of scrimmage when I was in Houston and Kubiak was the coach, and it's – you have – a play A, play B. Be usually a run or a pass, and you're going to call one of those two plays depending on what the defense is, and those are your only options. And sometimes both those plays are drawing dead, and the quarterback did not have the freedom to call a different one, did not have the freedom to check out of it. You cannot restrict Aaron Rodgers like that. You can't put that type of handcuffs on him. But Rodgers also, I think, in particular early on, can't every chance he gets, tweak, change, adjust. I think he has to submit.
Just for the sake of doing it, you mean?
Well, even if he thinks this could make it slightly better, because I think that could undercut the confidence not only of the coach, but of the other guys in the offense. Who are we listening to? We listen to the coach, we listen to the quarterback, or are those guys on the same page? They have to present a united front on this, because while Rodgers has been out of the playoffs the last 2 years, no one questions his ability. Matt LaFleur has never been a head coach. He is one of the younger guys. The Titans weren't great last year. This isn't a guy that is coming in where everyone's convinced this was the right hire. So he's got, Rodgers has to help him in that regard, just like LaFleur has to give him freedom to be Aaron Rodgers.
Is this too big? Are we making a big deal about this? Is this stuff that happens that great quarterbacks can audible at the line and we're just looking for some reason to find tension between another Packers coach and Aaron Rodgers? Mm-hmm. Or is this something that we should look into, maybe we'll beget something else further down the line as far as tension goes?
Well, anytime Aaron Rodgers is involved in the conversation, and given what the rumors were when McCarthy left, and given that the coach he has now has zero experience in the job that he has, one of the youngest that's ever been hired. Now, the game of football has done a 180. In the 70s and 80s, almost all the quarterbacks called their plays. And then here we come in the 80s and the 90s, and that's when Cal Shanahan learned this offense from his dad. And this comes from the late 80s. It's a spinoff of a Bill Walsh offense. Bill Walsh had audibles in his, but Shanahan, when he created his system, he took some of the audibles out of the system, took some of the flexibility out of the system. Mm-hmm. The reason why Matt LaFleur is not getting credit, because Kyle Shanahan got credit for that Atlanta offense. Yep. Because he was the coordinator, and even though he was the quarterback coach. So for me, I understand. I know the reason why he would teach Aaron Rodgers this. Why? It's the only offense he knows. Yeah. And that's what you start to get into. It's hard to be great when you don't have the variance of a lot of different things. That's why Bill Belichick and what they do is so amazing. They'll play a 34, they'll play a 43, yep. They'll throw it 50 times, they'll run it 50 times. They don't care. They look at the matchups and figure which one is best for us to win. And I just think that Aaron Rodgers, he can learn a lot from what's going on in New England. Tom Brady never complains about what they call and what they're going to do. He makes it work. Aaron Rodgers makes up excuses after the game. Now, they might be real, but they're not for us to hear. He's supposed to take the diplomatic approach after the game and blame it on himself, blame it on the teammates that he know are responsible, and then move on. Aaron hadn't done that, and that's what makes it a lightning rod with having this young coach matched with one of the best quarterbacks that we've seen play in the NFL.
I think Aaron Rodgers also has to understand that he can't do it all by himself, and hopefully the 2018 season will teach him that. I mean, they struggled. Now, I mean, his numbers weren't bad. He only threw two interceptions. 25 touchdowns, that's a little bit down from where we're used to seeing him. But there has to be a two-way street in terms of communication and trust between Matt LaFleur and Aaron Rodgers. And I think that's going to go a long ways to determining the success of this team. But the one thing I do like about what the Packers have done this offseason, not just hiring Matt LaFleur, but addressing the defensive side of the ball. And it's been several offseasons that they've continued to build on that. I mean, you got Mike Daniels, and they drafted Rashawn Gary in the first round in the trenches. You got those guys up front. And then what they did in the back end, drafting Darnell Savage to go along with some of their other draft picks in the secondary. Mm-hmm. I really like how they're trying to build this team, because they recognize they can't ask Aaron Rodgers to win a shootout 35-31 every single week. So at some point, you're going to have to be able to stop somebody. I think that they're setting it up to be able to do that. And then, of course, if you sprinkle in the element of the run game offensively, I think that makes life easier for Aaron Rodgers. And if you do that, you're going to get the best version of it.
You know a lot of football, so it's good that you said all that. Chris Caney, thanks for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.
So much good stuff. Did I do something wrong?
Nick went to the doctor yesterday. I hope he
I don't know what he got going on. I heard him in the hallway.
More first things first next.
We was going to be CC. We was going to be talking.